And their miserable parents give out a chemical that stops their young from growing around it. So the only hope for the young guys in this forest here is to have a friend like a cassowary who comes along and eats the fruit. The cassowaries have no teeth. They swallow the seeds whole. They walk around the forest. They drop it out the other end. Cone, lays at this point, walks to the female cone and delivers. At 3 o'clock in the afternoon, the female increases her temperature by 12 to 17 degrees to send the two beetles back to their own cone for good night's sleep and to collect some more pollen for the next day's exercise. This is going on for 2 weeks. We don't know a thing about it. And now we're beginning to find all these secrets. And we're doing it mainly through reading, but we're also seeing a lot of things ourselves that we couldn't see at the beginning. Yes, that's it, Sybil. Why can't we say the forest is 250? I really like to challenge these set figures that we're given. I don't like them. And it seems that we only have 2 cycles.
That fern up there in the tree, center of the finder, viewfinder, is about 1,000 to 1,500 years old. It's one of the first plants to have a seed.
Near the top, you might be able to see some flowers, a little bit of flowers.
The novel
to the fruit, so the fruit have come. Mm-hmm. So, on the edge,
the
middle of
the bark.
Well, if you know the gum trees, it's a stringy bark, it's a bit like that. It's not the gum itself, it predates the gums. But you can see similarities in the wood. I'll take you through this.
Oh, sure. Do you have iguanas here?
What?
Do you have iguanas?
Yes, where are you seeing it?
Climbing up for probably just much time.
I can see the head of it.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go over. It's a small body. That one's a... Come through here. Have a look at the thing. Look at the size of that ground.